Myself, Sandeep Javheri, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In today's session, we are going to discuss earthquake resistant features for buildings. The learning outcomes: at the end of this session, students will be able to enlist requirements of earthquake resistant structures and explain earthquake resistant features for buildings. Now, introduction part. The earthquakes takes place as a result of shaking of ground due to different reasons such as movement of tectonic plates. We cannot avoid earthquakes, but we can make our structures earthquake resistant so that there is minimum damage to properties and human beings. This damage or failure of structure depends on the amplitude and duration of shaking. So this is a figure which shows the damage to the building due to earthquakes. The requirement of earthquake resistant structures. According to Indian Standard Code, we should use the things which are mentioned in IS codes, which will helpful to make structure earthquake resistant. And we should strictly follow that the things which mentioned in the IS code. So Indian Standard Code must be used and strictly followed by the designers for design of structures. Building materials used must be of standard quality. It should be tested in the laboratory and as per standard which is given in the IS codes. The cement to be used must be checked for date of expiry and used within 3 months from the date of manufacture. The construction work must be carried out under expert supervision of engineer in charge with almost care. Steel to be used should not be corroded. So whatever the material we are using in the construction, it should be of good quality, tested, and it should be according to IS code. Now let us consider size of buildings. The size and shape of buildings play important role. Buildings should not be too high or too long. In tall buildings with large height to base size ratio, the horizontal movement of the floors during ground shaking is large. And also in tall buildings, the period of vibration is small, the frequency is large. You can see this is a tall building. In short but very long buildings, the damaging effects during earthquake shaking are more. So you can see this is a too long building. So in short, the building should not be too long or too tall. It should be of proportionate size. The size of buildings. In buildings with large plant area like warehouses, the horizontal seismic forces can be excessive to be carried out by columns and walls. So the size of building should be proportionate. Now let us consider horizontal layout of buildings. In general, buildings with simple geometry in plan have performed well during strong earthquakes. You can see the figure of rectangular plan and octagonal plan. So buildings with re-entrant corners like those U, V, H and plus sign shaped in plan have sustained significant damage. So you can see the complex plan in this figure L, T, U, V, X and Y. So horizontal layout of buildings, many times the bad effects of these interior corners in the plan of buildings are avoided by making the buildings in two parts. Now if you consider the L-shaped plan of a building, we can provide the separation joint here, and it will divide the L-shaped plan into two parts, that is two rectangular plot. This two rectangular part is shown in this figure. They are separated by separation joint. Now let us consider vertical layout of buildings. The vertical layout of buildings, the earthquake forces developed at different floor levels in a building need to be brought down along the height to the ground by the shortest path. Any deviation or discontinuity in this load transfer path results in poor performance of the building. And also, buildings with vertical setbacks which cause a sudden jump in earthquake forces at the level of discontinuity. So you can see here, the setback is given in this first case of building. In the second case, the setback is given, and because of that, there is a sudden jump of the earthquake forces that creates a discontinuity. So try to maintain or try to avoid these setbacks. Now avoid buildings on slopes. Many buildings with an open ground story intended for parking collapsed or were severely damaged in Gujarat during 2001 Bhuj earthquake, and buildings on sloping ground have unequal height columns along the slope, which causes ill effects like twisting and damage in shorter columns. So you can see this sketch of building on sloping ground. So the height of column is going to be changed, especially in the ground level. So because of that, there is a twisting and damage happened in shorter columns. So try to avoid to construct a building on sloping ground. Avoid floating columns. Now buildings with columns that hang or float on beams at an intermediate story and do not go all the way to the foundation have discontinuities in the load transfer path. So you can see in this figure, there is a column, that is floating column is there, and when the load is transferred from here, so it is having discontinuity in the transfer of load to this column, because ultimately the load is transferred to the ground. So this discontinuity should be avoided. That means we have to avoid the floating of columns. Prefer symmetric plans. So many buildings have been severely affected by this excessive torsional behavior during past earthquakes. Often the plan is simple, but the columns walls are not equally distributed in the plan. So buildings with such features lead to twists during earthquake shaking. So even though plan is symmetric or simple one, your position of columns and walls should be distributed in a proper manner so that we can avoid the twist during earthquake shaking. Use of horizontal bands. Horizontal bands are provided to make a masonry building earthquake resistant. According to IS 4236 1993, which is provided details regarding lintel band design, the lintel band ties the walls together and creates a support for walls loaded along weak direction from walls loaded in strong direction. So this is just like we are holding the card box by a belt, and this will move along the direction of motion. So that will tied that card box monolithically. Horizontal bands are the most important earthquake resistant features in masonry buildings. The bands are provided to hold a masonry building as a single unit by tying all the walls together. So because of provision of band at different levels, they tied this building, entire building, and work as a single unit. That is shown in the figure. So the lintel band is the most important of all and needs to be provided in almost all buildings. The gable band is employed only in buildings with pitched or sloped roofs. In buildings with pitched or sloped roof, the roof band is very important. So plinth bands are primarily used when there is concern about uneven settlement of foundation of soil. So you can see there is a plinth band at this level, lintel band at lintel level, roof band at roof level, and there is a gable band shown in the figure. So these are the questions that you have to answer. You are supposed to pause the video and you have to answer these questions. So these are the answers. The first statement is true because the vertical layout unnecessary offsets or setbacks should be avoided because that will create discontinuity in the transfer of load. Similarly, second statement is also true. To make earthquake resistant masonry structures, lintel band, plinth band and roof band is provided because it will act as a single unit. So this will resist the earthquake forces efficiently. Hence this statement is true. These are the references which is used for this video. Thank you.